So I'm just going to defend myself a little bit here. Show you what the slime ball looks like. It makes an AoE slow, attack speed, and other things. Show you briefly what a tunnel does. So you can put it anywhere in your vision, including in the shadow world, and then you can put it anywhere else. So I can send units from here to there, and it rallies to the enemy base. It's a nice ninja way to attack the enemy. Let me show you what it looks like. So it came through the tunnel, and now it's going to rally to the enemy base. Notice how there's a ramp in the backside of the enemy base. That's why the shadow world can be very useful. So this game's essentially controlling the nodes, controlling the land, setting up a nice attack, maybe coming through the shadow, and essentially outplaying your opponent. There could be rushes, there could be sneak attacks, there could be range, you could go with melee. And you just got to play around with all the different mechanics. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to my showcase of my action TCG that I made in the StarCraft II editing system. It took me about 8 months to develop this thing. I did this in about 2017 to early 2018. And in that time period, I was all set on getting this thing as sophisticated and developed as possible. And now looking in retrospect, I just wanted to make a video and actually show the world what I created. This game is a card strategy game that functions in real time. So there's a lot of mechanics and complicated things that need to be somewhat explained. Part of the video is going to be just going through the cards, going through the mechanics. And the other aspect is going to be demonstrating how the game functions as I play it. I'd have to say, there's a few cards that I really like that I made, but perhaps my favorite is the army base. The army base stores units in the form of guards, and they stack up to 20 times inside the army base, eventually doing massive damage, super efficient way of holding location. And on top of that, when that army base is destroyed by the enemy, every single unit that was in it comes back in that target location and starts going to the enemy base. So it is by far the biggest snowball mechanic in the game. Because if you think about the different mechanics in this game, you got investments such as the gas pump, you got investment units such as mineral farm, and then you have efficient units such as the dojo pumping out monks, you got the barracks pumping out soldiers, you got the dragon's den pumping out flying dragons, the airport pumping out flying jets, and you got the super nerd pumping out turrets. So those are the most efficient in kamikaze, except they all explode, but that's another efficient way of sending bombs to a location. So all those producing structures are efficient over time, of course, unless they're killed or unless they're not getting any value and the units coming out are instantly getting killed. And then you have units that are immediately super high value, such as the elephant. You know, he charges immediately to the wolf pack, only costs one and you get six immediately. It's a good way to kind of defend yourself. The rogue, for example, the sniper, you can just put them in a remote location. Towers, right? Everything's got a different way of getting value, and that's what I designed this game around. And the spells, they're generally ways to delay the game or gain some kind of CC effect immediately. And of course, you have the patrollers. The phantom's a good way of kind of ninja assassinating people, and then the monsters, a great way of growing in a certain area. This thing could end up being the most powerful unit in the game. If you're gaining 20 life per kill and life regen, eventually it becomes absolutely insane because it already does pretty decent damage. Of course, the rogue and the tech suit, they both have life leech mechanics. This guy is shield leech. This guy is shield leech. He also is armor piercing. So what's my point? My point is this is the most insanely designed game ever for an action TCG, and I've never seen anything like it. Shadow units, they are allowed to spawn in the shadow world, and they get additional benefits to being in the Shadow World. The Shadow World is just the outskirts of the map, and they're the only ones that can spawn in it, and they get a benefit. So you can essentially flank your enemy and play in the shadows if you would like. So I'm going to select a few units for the enemy to make here. And then I'm going to select the lineup. You can get up to 2 cards per deck. Of course, they all have custom sounds. And I did some voiceovers for it. And I did that voiceover as well. It says, "Ooh, master." Oh, master. Made that too. I'm self-impressed by my voiceovers, but I did not do that one. That one's from the game.
More efficiency.
Did that one. That's Roadhog from Overwatch. Anyways, I'm going to show you some of the units as we get in here. And let's just jump into it. So you can zoom in and out. You can go left and right.
And we're live.
Right? And you can scroll. So those are the basic commands there. There's some helpful tooltips everywhere. So I just picked an elephant with 4. I click it, and then I drag it to where I want it to go. After it goes to the point I send it to, it'll go directly to the enemy base and attack everything on the way there. Elephants have the charge mechanic. They gain double attack speed and movement speed for the first 8 seconds. Notice how I'm controlling this. I'm blue. I gain minerals over time for controlling this. The more I control, the faster the minerals I accrue. They allow me to make towers, catapults, and walls. So I can put a few down here, mess around with that, put a little wall here. The enemy cannot build in my base. I cannot build in the enemy's base, but I must build in line of sight of territory I can see. So I can build here, maybe send something around. I'm seeing in the creep here, first of all, let me defend myself. That didn't do much. But I can build in the Shadow World, right? So I could build, since I can see the Shadow World, I can build here, send it to wherever I want. It'll spawn some kamikazes there. Let's say I want to make some soldiers, move them around here. The Phantom is one of my favorite units. You can spawn it anywhere in the Shadow World, anywhere in the world that you see as well. Let's say I want it here and I want it to appear here. It'll send itself in Phantom form to the other location, start patrolling here, and then come back. It'll do it over and over. So it's a nice flank unit. It just died though to something, because enemy has a lot of units. So we got sound, we got the producing structure showing how many waves they have. It says 10, 10. All these things will rally the way they're supposed to. Of course, the idea is to destroy your enemy and he'll be building towers and units, and it's a strategy game in real time. So if I want to do some drops to target location, it'll drop some invaders every few seconds, assuming it doesn't die right now. I made a force field with my spell. I can send a vortex. And it'll suck all the enemies in here. And after a certain amount of seconds, it'll bring them out. It's a good delaying mechanic. I just built some towers here. You can press Alt to see all the ranges. I'm showing that right now. You can press Shift to toggle the detection range, because there are invisible units in this game. Essentially, there's a ton of mechanics in this game, and while it is complicated, once you get the hang of it, it's pretty straightforward. It's definitely a skill-based game. What I was trying to figure out when I was developing this game was, how fast do I want the gas to come back, because you're getting it automatically generated, and that determines the cost of your hand and your units in your hand. and how many minerals you're accruing from holding these nodes. Right now, I think it's a little bit too much. I can make a lot of towers just by holding one here. Well, let me just defend myself. This guy's not going to let me talk. I might end up... So I just lost the game. This is what would happen. Play some endgame music. And that's that. Start it up again. So again, it shows all the controls. Shows what kind of units there are. Their cards, rather, and what they do. So originally this game was designed for 6 minutes per match. Now it's at 10. Let me put some basic units. I have different rotating music, so it's not the same every single time.
I am a god. I am a god.
The guy says, I'm a god. And yeah, I did the voiceover. Sneaky tower, being sneaky and all that. Guy says, I'll fix it. He just repairs stuff between two target locations. Some One Punch Man music here.
Good luck and have fun.
So you can also cancel your summon by right clicking. It deselects the card. There's all sorts of little nifty tricks in this game, but the main thing to know is you click in a location you see, you drag it to a location on the map, and it goes and attacks everything in between where it spawned in there. And then it goes to the enemy base. So I'm just going to put out some units here, get them going. This guy's invisible, by the way. This guy's invisible, so they need detection. Like I said, towers can detect that this was the enemy tower, which you can see with this green. The green shows by toggling with shift the range of the detection. So they could detect it and kill it, but right now they don't see it. Let me defend my base. I'm making a few units here, casting some spells. That sound effect on me. So this guy's gonna make a turret every now and then, a little mini tower. It's a good way to kind of hold a location. Look at him just pumping out the... This guy's got value, that's all I gotta say. So I need six for the deity, I got six. I'm gonna send it against their deity. Oh, looks like my rogue got it as he's traveling to their base. Send a nice blaster. Let's go in there. So the idea, I don't know why this guy's not, they're not invading the base. It might be a bug. There's a couple bugs in this game, but usually they would rally the enemy base. So I'll show you what a nuke looks like real quick.
Place units within your vision.
I didn't place it within my vision. This time I did.
Place units within.
It's too slow. So let's send a ninja tactic over there. So he's going to run all the way there, assuming he's not detected, he's invisible. Look at this value this engineer is getting, man. The super nerd. He's doing work. Meanwhile, I'm accruing resources because I have the node. So I'm sending the nuke, it'll come down in 10 seconds. You hear it come. Boom, headshot. So it really depends on what's there, but it did some nice damage. It does some damage over time as well. That's a good voiceover. I used some StarCraft 2 packs. I used some other game sounds for making this game. It says from long range. That's from NBA Hang Time. And some of the soundtracks are from NBA Hang Time. Okay, so I'm going to have everything set to a few, maybe for the exception of just some general units. And I'm going to actually play this one out. And let's see how it goes. Gas pump has to be made in the Shadow World. So I'll just send this guy around. Put out. Now that I got 6 gas, so it's going to give me gas 20 times every few seconds. I'm going to go an investment heavy. Let me start with a few towers around my base. You can see the ranges. You can see the detection range. Make a nice mineral field. You can't build that. Oh, that has to be in the world. That's right. You can't put it on your cliff because I figured that was too OP to just protect in your base. So you got to put it somewhere here on the green. That's how the mineral field is made, whereas the gas pump has to go in the Shadow World. This guy has longest range in the game except for the sniper. Ooh, a rogue just took me out and took out my mineral field. Get a nice patrol going with my monster. I'm gonna send my sniper to patrol between this cliff. He says, "Watch my 360 no scope." So I got a couple snipers here. Looks like this guy's sending in another rogue. I gotta get some more minerals generating. This guy's taking up the map. Try to take this mineral node. Meanwhile, I'm being attacked. I am being onslaughted, dude. Alright, we defended ourselves. Getting some minerals, because we're going to need that detection. This guy's got rogues this game. Show you what the army base looks like. Put a sniper in the army base. I'm going to send some soldiers into the army base. This guy's just going hard, man. Make a wall here, just trying to do anything I can to slow this guy down. Put a force field out. Get some minerals going in the green. I'm just trying to breathe at this point. There's a few units I didn't allow to go in the army base. The Phantom might be one of them. Yeah, it looks like it is. Oh man, dude, they're just taking me out as soon as I make stuff. So they killed army base. Everything that was in it is coming out. All these soldiers I pumped into it, my sniper, etc., etc. I just want to get out of the spawn at this point. This computer, I put a gas pump down, by the way, right here. Croon some resources. I'm just trying to compete against this computer here. This guy is gunning for the win here. By the way, the bush has some bush-like mechanics that I put, like in League of Legends, for example. Dude, I'm just trying to slow this computer down. This is crazy. Computer too hard, question mark? I'm just going to try to reclaim this map here. Ooh, I got an army base. It looks like a bunch are coming here. I'm going to try to intercept my units. They'll go in, become guards temporarily until this thing dies. Oh, I'm getting nuked, though. That was a bad place to put my tank. Very bad. This guy has so many units. He's making this tough. He's got the middle completely controlled. He's not supposed to be able to make a catapult there, but the computer's different than players. You could say he even cheats. Alright, I'm going to go for a flank on this guy. That's going to be my plan here. I'm going to go through the Shadow World. Put out some defensive Oh, he has things on that cliff. I'm going for the flank. Shadow units can spawn in the shadow. Making sure I'm good at my base. With tab, you can go back to the base. He just has turrets everywhere, dude. This computer is going nuts. So my idea is they're going to rally here and then they're going to redirect straight to the base. So I'm just trying to get behind him, put a nice gas pump. He's not attacking me in the shadow. This guy doesn't even know I'm coming. Get a mineral field protected by my stuff here. Get some more turrets.
You can't build that.
I just realized I don't have a lot of units that can come in the shadow world. Maybe this strategy is not going to work. So, this computer is turtling quite crazily. So, I win because I was controlling two control points at the end. It also takes into consideration how many life points are left on both bases. It's a pretty turtly game, but I didn't really have the comp I wanted to flank this guy. I didn't have a lot of shadow units. And I also made him generate an insane amount of towers. So look how turtly he is. So that's the game. The games are a bit different when you're going against a real live opponent. It can end within seconds. It can end within minutes. It really depends what strategy you're going for. It depends what cards you select and how your opponent is playing and countering what you're doing. If this is a game you think you'd enjoy, let me know in the comments below. It took me a long time to make, and I haven't really had any other plans to develop it further. With that being said, thank you for watching, and until next time.